Good morning, Chilan. Welcome back to the social session where we were learning about the era of Rajiv Gandhi. Rajiv Gandhi, when he has come to power, all of a sudden due to the assassination of his mother Indira Gandhi, and his period is marked with large scale initiatives. His name is largely associated with the telecommunications revolution, and his name is also involved with many corrupt practices in the Prime Minister's office. So Rajiv Gandhi has introduced his first budget in 1985, which has taken the shape of more liberalized economy. So he was also convinced that India should adapt itself to the new technologies arising or emerging in the world, especially computers and telecommunication technologies. He initiated what we call it as a telecom revolution. And today, this is what we have seen in the previous class. Today, we shall learn about the rise of communalism and corruption in the high places, in the sense the top positions, even in the cabinet ministers, and prime minister himself is also involved in some kind of corrupted practices. So how it got involved and how this corruption got spread in the entire country, we shall understand in today's class. Communalism means the fight between the two religions is called as communalism. After the horrors of partition in 1947, partition, what kind of horrors we have already seen during the India's partition and independence movement. Under the unit called as partition and independence movement, we have already witnessed what kind of horrors we have faced. So there had been some attempt to keep religion away from the active and formal political sphere for all these years. From 1947 to 1980s, religion was not as a part of the political sphere. But this period, however, saw the emergence of new kind of political mobilization, which had communal overtones. That means, in the name of community, they started asking for the votes. They started mobilizing the voters. So that has become a new phase. This use of religion for political purposes and the partisan role of the government was going to lead a disastrous consequences, which would raise the question marks on the formal, on the issues of national unity and integrity. Desh ka unity or integrity ke bare mein bhi questions puchna shuru kar diye the. So keeping this one, in 1985, in the famous case of Shah Bano case, how this was how the Supreme Court has given a judgment in the Shah Bano case against to the Islamic law, we have seen. And according to that judgment passed by the Supreme Court, there was a what we call compromise between the political parties and the religious organizations, where the Muslim women was allowed to pay, Muslim husbands are permitted by the Muslim religious bodies to pay maintenance to the divorced wife or woman for only a short period of 3 months. This was widely seen as a compromising between the religious orthodoxy and ignoring the interests of the women of the community. This is Shah Bano case judgment, even though Supreme Court has given, but this has been diluted. The spirit of the judgment has been diluted by these religious bodies. So around the same time, some sections of the Hindus had begun a campaign for building a temple at Ayodhya, that is Lord Rama's temple they wanted to build at Ayodhya, in the place of the controversial construction of Babri Masjid. So in Ayodhya, there is a masjid called as Babri Masjid. In that place, the political activists as well as the Hindutva organizations wanted to build a temple in the name of Lord Rama. They claimed that it was the birthplace of Lord Rama. Okay, according to the scriptures, Ayodhya is the birthplace of Lord Rama. So it has been built, and they also claimed that this masjid has been built by destructing the Rama's temple there. So the custodians of Babri Masjid has denied. Custodians bole to uska dekhbhal karne wala, masjid ka dekhbhal karne wala jo custodians the, they have denied this and claimed that this was a place of worship of Muslims. This place had been under dispute for some time. So both salon say that was a disputed land. Disputed bole to controversial land tha both sal. and this place had been under the dispute in front of the court even, and it has been ordered to be kept closed except on one day in a year till the final decision was taken. Pure saal mein ek hi din open hote hai aur baki pure saal mein wo band karke hi rehte. That is the court judgment which was given. But in 1986 the court ordered that the mosque may be kept open on all days and allow Hindus to perform the worship on a daily basis. So 1986 में कोर्ट और एक जजमेंट दिया था उसको साल भर ओपन करके रखने के लिए और हिंदूज को अलो करने के लिए और हिंदूज वर्शिप करने के लिए भी, रोज़ वर्शिप करने के लिए भी दे हैव गिवन द परमिशन. सो इट वॉज वाइडली बिलीव्ड दैट दिस कुड ओनली बिकॉज द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट अप्रूव्ड ऑफ दिस डिसीजन. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट अप्रूव करने से ही ये डिसीजन सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने दिया था. एंड दिस ओपनिंग अप ऑफ द टेम्पल हेल्प्ड दोज ग्रुप्स हु वॉन्टेड टू कन्वर्ट द मास्क इन टू टेम्पल to mobilize a large number of people in the name of Lord Rama. And you know, there were many observers even. It appeared that established political parties were losing popularity among the people, and in order to divert their concentration, temple has become a center of attraction now. So we shall see further about the Ayodhya issue in the next class, children. Thank you.